I'm here at the Cradle of Aviation Museum for United Inc.'s Flight 913 Tattoo Show. There's plenty of exciting things going on here today, including photo shoots with the vintage planes. You can come and get a tattoo. You can come get your hair done by Hair by Millie Maddness. And then you can join the pinup contest at 4 o'clock. You could be in the pages of Rebel Inc. magazine.
Fucking awesome.
Join me inside. Anthony Talent's going to be videotaping. We're going to be talking to a few artists. Come on. Cradle of Aviation Museum, talking to Big Gus. What a pleasure. It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. What's going down?
Not much. We're just walking around and talking to all of our favorite tattoo artists, and you are definitely on the list for me. So tell me, how do you like tattooing in a museum?
Can I cuss? Because it's fucking awesome. Take two. No, really, it's sweet, man. Like I can't believe that I'm liking this, like, tent, like with an amusement park of airplanes right next to me. It's the coolest booth I've ever had, ever, in the years of tattooing at a show.
I agree. It's something that I actually had never seen. And to be tattooing inside an installation, it's amazing. It's absolutely amazing. So have you been working a lot this weekend, or are you just keeping busy with the fans and meet and greet?
Both. I get booked up before I come to shows, so I'm staying pretty busy, and then I have to deal with, like, people wanting to take pictures and buy our shirts and stuff, and so it's been great. I mean, everyone's like, oh, we're in the back in the museum, but we've had tons of people back here. It's awesome. I love that it feels like I'm, like, in this, like, cool airplane amusement park, and I'm tattooing inside of it, so.
That's really exciting. I can tell you as a fan, because I do definitely watch your show, of Tattoo Nightmares. It's on Spike TV, correct?
Yes.
And I don't want to misquote that. God forbid I misquote that. So, Tattoo Nightmares on Spike TV. They're filming their third season coming up this October, you say?
Yeah, in October we're going to start filming season 3, so everybody who watches our show, thank you. It's awesome.
It's actually one of the best tattoo shows out there, and that's coming from, I own a shop, so I pay attention. There's my artist. This is my artist's husband. Tell me a little bit about what it's like for you to be on television, balancing being an artist. Is that a little too deep for this?
No, I have to, like, kind of, like, blow away all the heat. The thing is it's, like, to balance, like, being an artist and then painting and to deal with the public, it's a lot of work. It's more than I could have ever imagined. So I didn't expect for our show to do as well as it did. I mean, I just love to do what I do, which is tattooing and drawing. So I just put that into the show and people responded. So to balance it out is kind of a hard balance because I want to incorporate a lot of my work into my clients when I tattoo them. At the same time, I have to give people the attention that they want at the same time. So it's not easy to balance out at the moment, but I'm working on it.
You seem to be doing a pretty good job. You're a pretty approachable fellow, and you seem to be really happy with what you do. I can tell you that, from my perspective, the Tattoo Nightmare show is a sincere show, and I think that's why it's actually been accepted as easily as it's been accepted.
I mean, well, me, Jasmine, and Tommy, we love each other, and we get along really well. So we're spending 17 plus hours a day with each other for those 5-6 months, and we actually like each other, and we help each other draw and tattoo, and, like, our goal initially is to give the client a brand new tattoo, even though it's still there initially. But if you can't get along with the tattoo artist that you're working with, I mean, we're not in competition or anything like that, so we're just genuinely trying to give people great tattoos.
I like that there's no drama on your show. I like that it's about the artwork.
Right, right.
Was that something that you guys established ahead of time?
Yeah, that was something that I actually spoke with the production company before I even said yes. So, because I didn't want to deal with the whole, like, we have some front counter person who wants to throw a tantrum type shit. And they're like, no, it's all about tattooing, and the drama's going to come from the clients, which is the stories, which are fucking hilarious. So it's great because for us, we can concentrate on tattooing, and the focus of the drama is on our clients, which is, it's a right. Great balance, you know what I mean?
Right. I noticed that's something I tend to like about it, too, is that the entertainment value really comes from the clients themselves as opposed to the artists, which you see in a lot of shows these days.
Right, right, right. And the clients bring a lot of humor to the place. Cause, I mean, some of them are sad and some are funny, but like I said, thank God they're the drama and we can focus on tattooing.
When will the new season air? You're filming it now, or you will be filming it in October, is that it?
Well, the new season starts filming in October, so we film for between 4 to 6 months, depending on how long the schedule's gonna be, but it won't start airing until next year, so it'll air like around February, March, depending on when they want to release the show. So this year we released it in June, season two, and it airs all the way through December and January of next year. It's 26 episodes long, so it's a lot of tattoo nightmares you guys can
watch. Well, I have it DVR'd. My husband can attest to that. We're often watching you laying in bed at night. I'm not going to lie. I go to sleep with you often.
Oh,
and
my
you
God,
don't even
that's the third time I heard that from a woman, and that's not bad.
Well, it's been a pleasure. I do have one more question just before I forget. Where is your show filmed? I'm curious. I haven't been able to figure that out.
It's filmed in Hollywood, California.
Is it filmed in California? I couldn't tell. Because it's really kind of, I like the way that it's nondescript, you know, because it's, again, about the tattoos. But I didn't know exactly where it was filmed. So
well, some people have figured out where we're at, but it's just a set location where they rent out another studio. But we're trying to work on establishing like a full studio that we're in charge of so that people have an actual location they can go to. But for now, it's just a set location. We don't work there, so don't look for us there.
I wasn't sure, and I got to tell you, I need to come in and decorate, because I was noticing, like, you sit down and you talk to the clients, and I'm like, why are there cinder blocks there? They need to decorate. You need a pinup to come in.
Shop, Spike, is what I need to do.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us. You can find Big Gus online, definitely Instagram. I follow you on Instagram.
Big Gus Inc. At Big Gus Inc.
And the website?
BigGusInc.com.
That's the way to go. And Spike TV. And the new season, you should expect a new season in the spring. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
I'm on these airplanes now. Peace out.
Thank you.